Hey everybody, good morning. This is Jeebs here, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge on a Friday morning. Had a long night last night, and well, you can probably hear by the tone of my voice, I didn't get much sleep, so I figured I need a little shot in the arm. And I'm reaching into the bag of Between the Buried and Me this morning. I figured, you know, my experience with them has always been like super eye-opening. So between my my death wish coffee and some between the Buried and Me, I'm sorry, it's early in the morning, and the song how appropriate too. This has been sitting around since April of last year in my suggestions. That's how deep my suggestion list is that I keep having to kind of like throw darts at. This is called The Coma Machine, which I probably would have loved to have had a little taste of last night to get some sleep. But, you know, still, I'm always in some kind of a good mood. I don't know where I drum that up, you know. So anyhow, I want to thank you guys like usual for your support, the cups of coffee, the shirt, the unabashed self-promotion, the shirts, the links are down below, the coffee. Patreon's been really important now because these long-form shows I'm producing with the members at Patreon. So if you don't want to buy me a cup of coffee or a shirt, but you want to, there's a bunch of reactions on there and stuff that are not released on this channel. Yeah, you want to check it out, you know, drop a couple dollars there. You can always back out in a month. And you've supported me, and somehow you get some good fun stuff in there. So stand by. Oh my gosh. Like, I'm not sponsored by Death Wish. Best coffee ever. I do pollute it a little bit with like vanilla nut creamer, but hey, my coffee is good money. All right, guys, let's do this. This is... Oh, you see, I had to even pull from that one last time. This is Between the Buried and Me, The Coma Machine. All right.
Stop somewhere. This is absolutely mental, man.
I don't know where to start with this. Well, first I was taken back by the piano. You know, a really unique thing about how they open this is that the piano is actually doing the chord changes, and the guitar is actually just banging out the same, like the root note, if you would, of the chord changes. You know, with the bass, it just stayed on one, you know, they just kind of chugged through it. This has got, up until this point, I was thinking as soon as they got into their, you know, Between the Buried and Me sound, you know, with the growling and the whole power and stuff, I'm going, okay, we're there. No way, these guys somehow managed to mix some, for me, from, you know, being an old composer, I don't know about some of the young listeners here who are pure listeners, has like this ELO kind of, who's the other guy I was just thinking of? Jethro Tull. And then this last section, even though they just fully dialed up the metal, had a lot of like, had the feeling for me of like some Danny Elfman Oingo Boingo kind of arrangement. So what I'm trying to say is here is these arrangements are very progressive and stuff. And I think my experience, though be it short, with Between the Buried and Me is a lot more of their straightforward, powerful music. This is crazy. I think there was one that I did also that showed me that they have a real, real solid artistic depth in their arrangements. They just are using what is more powerful sounds with these more intricate compositions. So if I would say, guys, I know this is a big base of Between the Buried and Me, like prog metal, theater to the mind kind of vibe that I'm experiencing here with this and stuff. And the way they're going in and out of their arrangements too is absolutely insane. I love also the fact that I'm getting an opportunity to hear the different use of the lead singer's voice and stuff. And if I'm correct, I'm still not thoroughly educated, but it's still one vocalist that's doing all the way across. There are bands now that I'm running into that have two different, you know, voices, and the drummer sings the clean, or it might be the darker voice or whatever. Bass, what I love too, and I've been really drooling on the bass lately because I've had to do a little bit of work, and just recently on my shorts, there's a question about bass that I put up there. But I love the way the bass is arranged through this. It's not what I would consider predictable, you know. So there's a lot of like very unique times when he's coming in on off time and wrapping phrases around. That's absolutely huge and stuff. All right, I want to get back into the vibe really quick. I want to take a sip of my coffee, so I'm going to shut up for a while. Let's get back to it. know everybody just went, no, here comes my favorite part. But I'm sorry, I got to stop. That drummer. Holy smokes. The work that he's doing on the rides and crossing over onto the hats and stuff, I mean, it's mind-numbing. It really is mind-numbing where musicianship has gotten since I was a kid, back in the 1900s, to where we are now. And it's just, that's what I love about this journey, man. I'm getting exposed to such incredible musicians that I feel like I never want to turn on my studio and ever write again. But it's insane. And also, oh my God, how can we not say that if they're pulling Queen so hard on this? You know what I mean? The textures and the depth of the arrangements and stuff like that, so progressive. And the musicianship on this is so freaking insane, man. It's just, Man, are you trying to tell me that this goes right into another song I didn't know? Please, please don't smoke the old man in the comments, okay? And on top of it, you know what it did? It dropped right into a commercial here on Spotify. So maybe I got lucky there. The musicianship in this is just absolutely, what's that term I see used here? On the internet, God tier. It just is, you know what, it's so many different infusions of influences on here, at least from my soundtrack of life. And I know for people who have very broad soundtracks of life and stuff like that, it might be different, but they're also pulling Steve Vai style work. those arpeggiations that are going on, and I can't imagine. I just have never been that kind of guitar player where I can hold a pattern perfectly for, you know, just forget it. It's not going to happen. Excuse me. But this was incredible. I know I'm not anywhere near probably maybe an eighth into their discography at best, maybe even a 16th. But this is incredible. This is the kind of stuff that gives me that kind of, I've heard so many great bands, so many great musicians. I feel like a 16-year-old, and I feel like I'm just at the very beginning of understanding how incredibly powerful and musical metal and rock is. And I feel like I've ripped myself off by not rinsing in it my whole life. But between The Buried and Me, this kind of composition, this kind of musicianship, and this type of creativity is so enlightening for me, you know what I mean? There's a part of me that I'm so excited, and there's a part of me that I'm so pissed because I feel like I've missed, you know, just such an amazing journey my whole life. But hey, I'm 60, and God willing, I might have another 10 minutes, 10 years, 20 years plus to rinse as much as I can. So, you know, as long as I have my Death Wish coffee, just my attitude, I'm just so looking forward to continue diving, you know, here between The Buried and Me. And speaking of which, I want to say that there's a poll in my community tab, and it's right there between between The Buried and Me and I think Alice in Chains on what one of my long forms is going to be. So you may want to check that out, you fans. But this was just great. And thank you so much. There was one comment that came in about an hour or two ago that made me go, okay, I've seen this come up too many times. I've got to hit this song. You know who you are. All right, guys, thank you so much. Have a killer weekend. If you're still here, type in I'm still here. And also, like usual, thank you for any kind of support. Share it, like it, comment on it, even dislike it. I don't care. Just hit a button. I'm dying. All right, guys, listen. Take care. Have a killer weekend. Aloha. Fuck, that was great. All right.